Everyone gets frustrated and frazzled with their jobs from time to time, but workplace burnout can leave people feeling anxious, irritable, and just downright exhausted. So how do you know if you're on the brink of severe burnout, and what can you do to stop it? Erica Diamond is a success coach and the founder of the popular women's lifestyle blog, womenonthefence.com. She joins us from Montreal this morning with some advice. So good to see you.
Good morning. It's great to be here.
So what exactly is burnout? Because this isn't just someone having a bad day, is it?
No, it's certainly more than just a bad day. So what burnout feels like, and I had many of the symptoms. I was very close to a severe burnout in 2001. But what burnout feels like is a feeling of anxiousness, anxiety, agitation, so everything ticks you off, lines at the bank, traffic, everything gets you all riled up. Feeling of a lot of stress and sleepless nights. For me, it was sleep was a very big problem. What happens is when you're not sleeping well and your mind is racing, this leads to more anxiety throughout the day and feeling of just not wanting to get out of bed in the morning for many, the feeling that you just don't want to go to work, the feeling of really exactly like the word says, like burnt toast, just burnt out. You're overdone, overcooked, and you're at your wit's end.
I know for a lot of women, there's that question of balance, trying to balance work life, trying to balance family life. I know it's the number one question I get when people talk to me about it. And I always respond with, I've thrown balance out the window. To me, it doesn't exist. You can't do it. It's too much to live up to. So you just do the best you can. When you're with your family, you're with your family. When you're working, you're working. What do you make of that?
I absolutely agree with you. For me, there's no balance. Some days are great, some days are not. All you can do on any given day is your best. And for me, it's about prioritizing. So it's exactly as you said. When I'm at work, I'm focusing on work. And when I'm with my children, it's about being present and in the moment. Otherwise, you're never actually living in the moment. And when you're at work, you're worrying about home. And when you're at home, you're worrying about work. And those kind of things do lead to burnout when you're not fully living in the moment.
So let's look now, Erica, at some ways that people can avoid burnout. The first step you say is you've got to get help. You've got to admit that there's an issue here.
Yes, and for me, that aha moment was, I think my mom, she looked at me and she said, Erica, there is something up with you. You need help. So I went into therapy for a year, and that was the greatest gift that I could have given myself. So for me, it was about getting help. Once every 2 weeks, I went to see a therapist, and just having an objective ear and someone to talk to makes all the difference. So get help. Admit that you need help and get that help that you need.
We talked about balance just a second ago, but you're talking about something different here. You're saying it's important to balance your life. In which way?
So the greatest thing that she said to me was, that my therapist said to me was, no one's telling you have to compromise your gifts. In other words, you don't have to stop working and stop working hard and minimize what makes you successful. What you have to do is balance this hectic pace with more calming activities and a more calming lifestyle. So for me, that was the birth of yoga. For you, that may be meditation or a walk at night or the gym or Pilates, something to complement this hectic pace for you with a more balanced, calming lifestyle.
You also recommend, Erica, and I find this interesting, writing down a worry list. Is there something therapeutic to actually writing things down?
The worry list. The worry list was my saving grace. So the worry list works as follows. You keep a notepad and a pen on your nightstand, and when my thoughts and my mind was racing at night, what I had that pen and paper there for was it off my mind and onto paper to worry about at another time and not during my sacred time of sleep. So that worry list still sits on my nightstand, and if I'm awake at night and my thoughts are keeping me up, I take them out of my head, write them onto paper to deal with tomorrow, but not during sleep, not during your precious time where you deserve to sleep.
And often people who work very, very hard do everything, they try to get everything in, but your fourth tip is learn your limits. There's got to be limits and know what you need.
Know your limits. So again, that was something that I learned and I still practice that today. So that means if I'm hungry for lunch at 10:30 in the morning, I eat. It means that if I'm tired at 8 o'clock at night, I go to bed. It means not conforming to what society says you should be doing. And it's about listening to your body. It's really, really important that you listen to what you need and not to what everyone else is doing, to listen to your own body. It's very important.
Good advice, Erica. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you so much for having me.
For a link to Erica Diamond's blog or to get a list of things you can do to avoid burnout, visit our website, canadaam.ctvnews.ca.